The question says, gem dibromide is. Gem dibromide is. Always keep in mind, gem dibromide is an example of gem dihalide. About gem dihalide, we have learned two halogens are directly connected to the carbon. Two halogens are directly connected to the carbon. For example, we have CH3 and then we have CH. We can see two halogens are directly connected to the carbon. This is the halogen, this is also halogen connected to the same carbon. Hence, we can say gem dihalide. This is what gem dihalide is there. Okay, now you can see we have first compound is there. In this case, CH3 is there, CH. To this CH, Br is attached, and to this CH, OH is also attached. And then we have CH3 there. You can see these two are different functional group. Two halogens are not there. One halogen is there. So it is monohalide. It is not dihalide. If I go to the second option, you can see we have CH3, C, and then Br is attached. Here also Br is attached, and then we get CH3. You can see to the same carbon, two halogens are attached. Hence, we can say option B is an example of gem dihalide. Okay, option B is an example of gem dihalide. You can see in the option C, only one halogen is attached. Hence, it is monohalide. In this case also, you can see this is D option. If I talk about D option, you can see the structure. We have CH2. We have CH2Br. CH2Br is there, CH2Br, let me write here, we have CH2Br, and you can see CH2Br is there. Okay, this is the compound we have in the option D. You can see halogens are not connected to the same carbon, they are connected to the adjacent carbon. And if this kind of situation is there, two halogens are connected to the adjacent carbon, hence it is vicinal dihalide, weak dihalide we say. It is not a gem dihalide, it is weak dihalide. Okay, so you can see option D representing weak or vicinal dihalide, and option B is representing gem dihalide. If you like this video, please share and subscribe to the channel.